You got the right answer, but you get no prize for that. It was too simple. As you see, it's very simple. The Jews say he was alive. The Christians say he was alive. The Muslims say he was alive. No prize. The storm subsides and a fish comes and gobbles him up. Dead or alive?
Alive.
Right. From the fish's belly, he prays to God for help according to the book of Jonah. I'm asking, do dead men pray? Dead people, do they pray? No. So he was?
Alive.
Alive. A little louder, please.
Alive.
MashaAllah.
Three,
you will be given the opportunity at question time, whoever you are, you will be given the opportunity at question time to ask questions. Be man enough, be Christian enough to please keep your mouth shut for the moment. 3 days and three nights, the fish takes him around the ocean. Dead or alive?
Alive.
Alive. Don't be afraid. Don't get terrified. On the third day, the fish vomits him on the seashore. Dead or alive?
Alive.
Alive. Look, whether you are a Hindu or a Christian or a Jew or a Muslim, if you read this record and if you had sound common sense, you will say alive, 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 alive. And it's a miracle. It's a miracle of miracles. When you throw a man into a raging sea, he ought to die. If he died, no miracle. Because we expect him to die. A fish comes and gobbles a man. He ought to die. If he died, no miracle. If he didn't die, it's a miracle. Heat and suffocation in the belly of the whale, the man ought to die. 3 days and three nights, he ought to die. If he died, no miracle. No mojiza, no sign. If he didn't die, it's a miracle. So it's a miracle of a miracle of a miracle. An outstanding miracle in the Bible, three times over. It's a miracle from every point of view. So Jesus says, for as Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the whale, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the belly of the earth. As Jonah was, so shall the Son of Man be. I'm asking, how was Jonah for 3 days and three nights in the belly of the whale? Dead or alive?
Alive.
I'm asking again, how was Jesus in the tomb for 3 days and three nights? Dead or alive?
Alive.
I beg your pardon?
Alive.
No, according to Christendom. Dead. Ask the professor, ask the doctor. He said he was dead for 3 days and three nights. Jonah was alive for 3 days and three nights. Jesus was dead for 3 days and three nights. Any Christian worth the name will tell you that. Any Christian. You don't have to be a DD and you don't have to be a theologian or a preacher or an evangelist hearing voices from heaven, you need nothing. Jonah is alive. The Christian says Jesus was dead. I'm asking in your language, you English speaking peoples, you Americans who speak English, the Englishman who speaks English, I speak English. I speak English as my mother tongue. See, this is the nearest, because psychologists say that your mother tongue is the language in which you dream and the language in which you swear. And I dream in English and I swear in English. So from that angle, I'm also an Englishman. See, I'm an English-speaking person, though my mother tongue is Gujarati, I speak Urdu, I speak half a dozen different languages, but my mother tongue is English according to the psychologist. So I'm asking in your language, those, I'm sure all of you understand English. Otherwise, you wouldn't be here. I said, in your language, you see, is this like Jonah or unlike Jonah? Jesus says, for as Jonah was, like Jonah. Jonah is alive, Jesus is dead. Is that in your language, like Jonah or unlike Jonah? In your language.
Unlike.
Unlike. So I'm asking now, is Jesus speaking the truth or you speaking the truth? Is Jesus a liar or you are a liar? Either. Look, you both can't be right. He says, I'll be like Jonah, and you telling me he's not like Jonah. So he failed or he lied or you are lying. Yes. You have to admit that you have misunderstood the whole thing. You're reading this in your own language, simple basic English, King's English or Queen's English. This language I'm talking. For as Jonah was, so shall the Son of Man be. Like Jonah, not unlike Jonah. The very learned person, he says, no, Mr. Deedat. You see, Jesus is here emphasizing the time factor. I said, there is nothing miraculous about a time factor. Whether a man is, dead, I mean unconscious, or gone into hibernations for 3 minutes, 3 days, 3 hours, 3 years, that is not a miracle. The miracle is that you expect a man to die and he doesn't die. That's a miracle. But drowning man clutches at straws. You see, he says, no, Mr. Deedat. You see, it is the time factor that Jesus was emphasizing. Can't you see? He said, for as Jonah was 3 days and three nights, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights. He repeats the word 3-4 times. So it's the time factor that he was emphasizing, not whether dead or alive. So I'm asking, look, did he fulfill that? The time factor. Did he fulfill that? He said, yes. I said, look, you're going to make another slip just now. You're going to fall again. You have made one faux pas. You have made one mistake. You have accused Jesus of lying. He said, I'll be like Jonah. You say he was unlike Jonah. He didn't fulfill it. And you're going to make a second mistake just now. But no. Drowning man clutches at straws. And you'll find drowning women will do the same. So I said, now, look, when was he crucified? When was Jesus crucified? And Christendom as a whole, they give you the answer, Good Friday. Have you heard of Good Friday? Do you have Good Friday in your country here? We have it in South Africa. They call it in African, Hui Vrydag. See, Good Friday. In South Africa, we celebrate Good Friday. Swaziland, Basotho, Zambia, Zimbabwe, Britain, France, Germany, Italy, name them. Every Christian nation on earth commemorates Good Friday. What makes Good Friday good? They say Christ died for our sins. Is that what makes it good? I said, yes. So it was on a Good Friday. I said, yes. I said, okay. When was he crucified, morning or afternoon? When? Well, some say morning, some say afternoon. I say, I won't argue. Whatever you say, I accept. How long was he on the cross? Some say 3 hours, some say 6 hours. I say, I won't argue with you. I won't argue. You say three, I accept. If you say six, I accept. I said, the Jews were in a hurry to put him up on the cross. That's the reading of the scriptures. Why were they in a hurry? Because they were afraid of the common people. Jesus was a hero to the common people. He had healed the blind, the lepers. He had given life back to the dead. On one occasion, he fed 5,000 people with a few pieces of fish and a few pieces of bread. On another occasion, another 3,000 people with a few pieces of fish and a few pieces of bread. A man with such a reputation, the people loved the man. And if his life was endangered, there might be a revolt, a riot. So quickly, apprehend the man and get rid of him. So they grabbed him and they take him, had a midnight trial, which doesn't happen in Jewry. Midnight trial, early in the morning, they take him to Pilate. And as if Pilate had nothing else to do, he was waiting. He receives them and Pilate says, look, this is not my kettle of fish. Take him to Herod. They take him to Herod. Herod had nothing to do. He was also waiting. Nothing to do, these royal people. Nothing to do. They're just waiting. And he said, look, he says, take him back to Pilate. They take him back to Pilate. Pilate is still waiting. All these things happen at the double. Only these things happen in films, in your Hollywood. In real life, it doesn't happen. But whatever you tell me, I said, I accept. No arguments. So finally, they get him on the cross. We are told about 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And he's there for about 3 hours, according to the Christians. As much as the Jews were in a hurry to put him up, queer people, they were also in a hurry to bring him down. You know why? Amazing. They were in a hurry to put him up, now they're in a hurry to bring him down from the cross. You know why? Because of the Sabbath, Yom HaSabbat. Because they were told in the book of Deuteronomy that they must see to it that nobody is hanging on the tree on the Sabbath day, that thy land be not defiled with the Lord thy God giveth thee for an inheritance. So for that, it was a filthy, dirty, sacrilegious thing for anybody to be hanging on the cross on the Yom HaSabbat, Sabbath day. And Sabbath begins at 6 o'clock on Friday. According to the Muslims, the Jews, Our day begins at sunset.